Now let's talk about some skill-focused activities. One of my favorite ways to use the newspaper is as a source of words, and one of my favorite tools is the bingo game. Here's how it works. For the game, you will need to have one bingo sheet for each student in your class. You'll need a transparency that you will use on an overhead in front of the classroom, and each of the students will need a copy of the newspaper. Let's assume you want to focus on faraway places or places outside the United States. Ask the students to find places in the news journal that are outside the United States and raise their hand. As they call out the words, you write each of the places on one of the boxes in the bingo game. The students also select one of the boxes on his or her bingo game and fills in that word. You also have a class secretary who writes each of the words on a small piece of paper, and you'll use those later as your marker. You continue having the students find the words and tell them to you and spell them as you write them in the boxes until you have all 25 boxes filled with words. Then it's time to play the game. From the class secretary, you take those little pieces of paper and randomly pull out the places that have been selected. You put those on the transparency, covering the appropriate box in the bingo game, on the overhead projector, and the students mark each of the boxes with X's as the place is called. Finally, someone will have a bingo, all five in a row. Traditionally, when you play a bingo game, the person proves that they have the bingo by calling back the numbers to the caller. However, this is geography bingo, so go to the front of the class and pull down a map of the world. Now, instead of just identifying the names of the places, the student who has the bingo must come up and find all places on the map. Now, what are the odds of that one student knowing all of those places? Probably not very high at first, but he or she may know one or two, and you point out the other ones. Have the student go back to the seat and continue on with the game until someone else has a bingo. Pretty soon, the students will start to realize that if they really pay attention, when the places are pointed out on the map, they will have a very good chance of winning the bingo game. Think of all the different skills that are involved in this. The students have seen the name in the paper. They have heard someone spell it. They have printed it on their paper. They have called it back to you, have located on a map of the world. All of those things that if you had to put into one lesson plan might be very tedious. However, in the form of the game, would be a lot of fun. And of course, the person who wins the bingo and can find all five places gets to pick which of the five stories to read to the class. Bingo has lots of uses, and I'm sure you'll find many more in your classroom.